that the law, representation of the people's act, stipulates who are lawfully allowed to use proxy votes. Proxy votes is a big thing in larger democracies. You are living abroad, that doesn't deprive you of being able to pass your vote. In the case of Belize, we have limited the category of persons who can cast a proxy vote. A proxy vote means, for example, that police officers who are on duty are given a form which they will sign in the presence of a justice of the peace as witness to say that I am authorizing my wife, my brother, whatever family member, good friends, to vote on my behalf. So the election officials know who all are allowed to have proxies and who all have appointed a particular person to be their proxy, so that they have that on record. So on election day, a person turns up, the authorities in his respective divisions know that, okay, the actual voter is a police officer, a medical worker, a public officer who is doing election duty, and so on and so forth. The law lays down who are allowed to utilize the proxy vote, meaning somebody is your agent voting on your behalf. There is no provision in the law for persons with health problems or infectious disease to vote by proxy. Had we been discussing this matter ahead of time, had we been doing this, perhaps the authorities could have given thought to making an amendment to the law to allow for proxy voters for COVID persons. But we don't have that culture. We are not a people who look into the future. We don't do no planning. So here we are, the House of Representatives has been dissolved, so they can't make any law. They can't change any law. They can't amend the proxy law. So that route is not available because we are not a forward-looking people who are discussing and planning matters. So that is not an option at this late stage.